Hi guys, in this experiment we are going to see about a speed control of DC shunt motor. So this is the circuit diagram. Okay, the objective of this experiment is to control the speed of DC shunt motor using armature control method and to control the speed of the DC shunt motor using field control method and to find the armature resistance and to obtain the characteristics of speed control by the above mentioned methods. So the apparatus required will be voltmeter, ammeter, rheostat and tachometer. So the voltmeter, ammeter and rheostat we should take in the corresponding ranges. Okay, before moving to the procedure, first precautions we should take care is that the fuse is selected in such way that it is rating is 120% of the no load current. The spring balance should be kept at zero position throughout the experiment. The motor field rheostat should be kept at minimum position at the time of starting. So the procedure for the field control method is: first, the DPST switch is closed and the motor is started, and the motor is started using the 3-point starter. The voltmeter connected parallel to the armature should be kept at constant voltage by not varying the armature rheostat. The field rheostat is varied and corresponding readings are noted down in tabular column. The same procedure is repeated for different armature voltages. So and finally we should plot a graph between IF and the speed of the motor. Okay, for field control method I have just made VA is equal to 208 volts, and with the corresponding voltage I have just increased the rheostat value, and then I have taken IF and speed values. So like this you can take two or more readings with varying the VA in corresponding like 10 or 5 volts. So this is for the field control method. For the armature control method, the procedure is: again, the DPST switch is closed and the motor is started using the 3-point starter. The armature is connected in series with the field rheostat. This field rheostat, the field current IF is maintained at a constant value by adjusting the field rheostat. The armature rheostat, now the armature rheostat is varied and the corresponding readings of EB and N are noted down. N is the speed of the motor. The same procedure is repeated for different value of different field currents. And finally, we're gonna plot a graph between EB and the speed of the motor. So the final tabular column will be like this for the armature control method. For field control method, the voltage is maintained constant, but for armature control method, current is maintained constant. After noting down all the values, we should plot the graph. Before that, I will show the model calculation for this. So the formula will be EB is equal to VA minus IARA. With this formula, we can find the value of EB. So we're gonna plot these two graphs. For field control method graph, you can take speed in y-axis, and then field current, that is field current IF, in x-axis. So the graph will be like this. And for the armature control method, you can take speed in y-axis and armature voltage in x-axis. So the graph will be like this. So with this, the experiment is over. You can take a look of the Viva cushions. You can take a screenshot of this, are you just gonna see? These are some questions they will ask for Viva. Thanks for watching this video.